Simple mail transfer protocol or SMTP allows any system on the internet to send email to a mail server using any source IP address. This feature is exploited by hackers while they send phishing emails to a mail server using the source IP address of a trusted party, for example, a bank domain, so that the receiving system and the user believes that this email has come from a trusted party and therefore discloses his private information. This also provides a kind of anonymity for the hacker, since the source IP address of the email in phishing emails is spoofed. Therefore, it would be difficult to trace a hacker. Now, this vulnerability of SMTP is also exploited by spammers, where they send spamming emails with forged or spoofed IP address to a mail server and thus avoids any responsibility for spamming a target. In this video, I will discuss a method known as Sender Policy Framework or SPF, which is used for email security by detecting such emails with forged source IP address. Now, this is a domain name server of a domain. This domain name server or DNS has an SPF record which contains the IP address for the mail server or SMTP server of this domain, which is authorized to send email on behalf of this domain. So once this authorized mail server sends an email to a mail server which is outside the domain, then the receiving email server checks the envelope of this domain, which contains the source IP address. So the receiving email server checks the SPF record of the domain which has the source IP address, whether the SPF record contains the SMTP IP or the whether the source IP address of the email is the one which is used as authorized IP address by this domain. So if everything checks out well, then the body of this email is allowed on the receiving email system. This provides protection against spamming emails, and more specifically, a special effect of spamming emails on the domain whose IP address has been forged in spamming email. So there is a back scattering effect on the actual source IP address which is used in the spamming emails, where the receiving email system sends automatic or erroneous messages to the source IP address which is there in the spamming email. So thus, these automatic messages or erroneous messages goes to the actual domain and thus creates lot of spamming effect or backscattering effect on that domain. So once a domain publishes its SPF record and declares the SMTP or authorized mail server IP addresses, then the receiving email system does not send such automatic messages to that domain, even if these are contained in a spamming email. or used as a source address of these spamming email. Moreover, there is a service known as DNS-based black hole list or DNS-based list or blacklist, which is used to check the spamming reputation of an IP address. So once a receiving email system receives an email, it checks the source IP address or gets its source IP address validated from this service by sending a DNS query. So if the DNS-based blacklist declares that this IP address is reputation has been that of a spamming, then this email gets dropped. Otherwise, it is accepted by the receiving mail server. So once a domain has placed the SPF record in its domain name system, therefore it is less likely to be used by spammer as the source IP address of their spamming emails, since such spamming emails will get filtered at the receiving email system if the receiving email system has configured the SPF checks. So therefore, this domain which has put in or configured the SPF for its authorized SMTP server on the DNS server, then the reputation of this domain name with regards to the DNS blacklisting would be good. Therefore, the emails which are generated from the authorized mail server of this domain will get accepted by most email servers. Now there is a vulnerability in this entire sender policy framework, that is, if the hacker has hacked the DNS server of a domain and thus created the fake accounts which are authorized to send email on behalf of this domain, or either the hacker has hacked the actual authorized SMTP server. So this was all from my side. Please stay connected. Thank you.